Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Secretary General Metropolis, Secretary General Ban Ki-moon, Executive Director of Federal, President of the IMO Assembly, Commissioner Admirals, distinguished delegates, observers, ambassadors, and excellencies. I'm very honored to be here today at the IMO as it makes piracy the focus of 2011. We have heard the high cost of piracy to the world economy, to the Horn of Africa, and to the well-being of seafarers who risk their lives each day at the open sea. But I also want to today emphasize the severe humanitarian cost, as the Secretary General raised. The World Food Program knows the importance of open sea lanes. Every year, we move food throughout the world to deliver about 40 billion meals, up to 40 billion meals for people who would otherwise perish or face severe malnourishment due to a lack of access to food. And we ship that food every day on the high seas. There's no place more vulnerable to having that lifeline cut off today than Somalia. This is a critical time for Somalia, where land transportation really isn't an option to maintain that lifeline for the up to 2.4 million people we have to reach daily who desperately need the intervention. Therefore, piracy off the coast of Somalia in our world is first and foremost a threat to the people of Somalia themselves, particularly for the most vulnerable women and children who rely on this global lifeline for their daily sustenance. Somalia is a food deficit country, with 1.5 million displaced people fleeing conflict, deprivation, and some of the highest malnutrition rates in the world. In the south of the country, a staggering 1 in 4 children are suffering from acute malnutrition. And we know if the children under 2 are not reached with an intervention of nutritious food, their brains will never fully develop in life and it cannot be recovered. This lifeline is critically important. Ocean transport remains the main and most cost-effective and fastest means of relief for food delivery to Somalia. Cost-effective is very critical in our world, because we try to put as much as we can into this cup of nutritious porridge to put as much of the money that we're contributed in the voluntary contributions to us into this cup. And the transportation, as you know, and food are deeply embedded, and we need to find cost-effective and safe ways to deliver this. Just about all of our food in Somalia arrives by sea. This is one of the world's vital humanitarian lifelines, and it cannot be cut off. We know that without food, people really only have 3 options. They can migrate, they can revolt, or they can die. This is a great threat to regional and international security when people are cut off from food. By ensuring the unhindered supply of WFP's cargo to other destinations, we will not only be containing the spillover effect from Somalia, but ensuring stability for the region in its own right. That's why we called on the world to help us secure our vital food shipments to Somalia in 2007, and the world responded and saved lives. In fact, since November 2007, in a system worked out with the Secretary General's team and the Secretary General of IMO and the team here and NATO, since that time, we have been able to transport more than 600,000 metric tons of life-saving cargo directly to Somalia, largely unhindered due to the provision of a system of escorts. And I just want to mention, much of this happens under now an operation called Operation Atalanta, but also individual countries have made a huge difference. And I see all of you here today, and I just want to mention some of the countries that have played a key role. France, Denmark, the Netherlands, Canada, Belgium, Italy, Sweden, Germany, Spain, Greece, the UK, Norway, Lithuania, Estonia, and others through diplomatic support and means, but these are direct support with ships and provisions to do this. I think this is one of the most dramatic examples of collective action to protect the most vulnerable people on the earth that I have seen. And one of the great multilateral success stories and one of the great humanitarian success stories. And I want to thank all of you deeply from the bottom of our hearts. All of your interest in this is very important to us. We're on the front lines in some of the world's most dangerous places. But what's at stake is very big and goes beyond our world. And so we need all of your solidarity and help. Before this system started, there were many attacks, threatening this food lifeline, holding it up, blocking it, and cutting children off from food. We had, just in 2007, before we called for action, three attacks, and one ship was attacked twice, the MV Rosen, and held for 40 days and for 6 weeks in 2007. The naval escorts have not only helped WFP protect cargo, but also helped us charter vessels. It's hard to get vessels in when they're regularly attacked, as you know. In 2010, there was a short time period when we couldn't find ships to bring our food in because of a short gap in the escort system. We need the escort system to stay functional and to be on this vital case. We are extremely grateful to all the nations that have committed to this cause. This has meant that no ship carrying WFP food into Somalia has been hijacked since the start of the escort system. However, today we're faced with new challenges. The presence of Somali pirates in an ever-expanding area is of great concern to the World Food Program because they threaten not only now food bound for Somalia, which we have addressed that issue, but our food transiting through the ports of Mombasa in Kenya, Dar es Salaam in Tanzania, and Beira in Mozambique. This lifeline and these ports are our lifeline to reaching millions of people, for example, in the Kivus, in the Democratic Republic of Congo, in Zimbabwe, and elsewhere. This lifeline must not be shut down. For example, in 2009, the Maersk Alabama carrying WFP vital food for Kenya, Uganda, and Somalia was hijacked. In Kenya, WFP reaches 4 million desperately food insecure people, including 380,000 Somali and Sudanese refugees, and provides critical nutritional support to 180,000 of the extremely young children. And now, the MSC Panama is being held. And I would just like to mention this. On December 12th, the ship was seized with 200 containers of urgently needed food for the Kivus in DRC and Zimbabwe. It's still being held, and it literally takes out of the mouth of vulnerable babies, women, the elderly, the most vulnerable, the simple cup of food they need a day. This is very hard to explain in the Kivus why that cup is empty when that supply line shuts down. I want to thank again all of you here for your help, reiterate the importance of continuing these, and to say that we very much support the Secretary General Ban Ki-moon's call for multifaceted action to deal with the root causes of these problems. Today, the International Labor Organization and the World Food Program run an innovative food for work program in Puntland and Somaliland that provides training for jobs in exchange for the vital food and is bringing hope to those areas. At the World Food Program, we can do many things. We can be innovative, we can be courageous, and we can be brave. And in fact, A number of WFP staff have made the ultimate sacrifice to make sure this cup is filled for the children of Somalia and have lost their lives. But we need you. And I just want to put in an appeal. We're voluntarily funded, and this lifeline, in fact, has no funding at the end of March. We're $39 million short to keep reaching the people of Somalia. A severe drought has set in. I just got a call from the Prime Minister saying urgently to get the message to the world that we need to make sure the lifeline is sustained. I want to thank you again for your leadership, and it means very much to the hungry women and children of the world. I meet them regularly, I see them, and they always send their thanks to the world. So thank you very much.